Add an email to your iPhone, your iPad, or even your iPod. Before we start, we need to do a couple of things. You're going to need 4 or 5 settings that would include your email address, your username. This could be the same as your email address. Also, you're going to need your password. Hopefully that's nice and secure password. Your incoming mail server and your outgoing mail server. That also might be down in your settings as SMTP. And you're also, click the subscribe button if you want more videos on saving time and growing your business using the internet. So grab your phone. We're going to need to jump to the settings icon. Click on that. And if you scroll down, what you're looking for is the mail icon. So if you scroll down to mail, tap that. If you go to accounts, now we want to add an account. Now you'll see the selection at the top. We've got iCloud, Microsoft Exchange, Google, Yahoo. If your account is with one of them, you would probably may have only been given 2 settings. That may be your email address and a password. Generally, that's all you need to get into these type of services. They use something called Auto Detect. It detects the settings because they know what it is. And or if you just got those 2 settings, enter that and that's your email set up. What would be really interesting to know, is this email you're setting up for yourself or is it for a company you work for? So is it your business? So if you put in the comments, your business or a company you work for, so work or own business, just drop that in the comments. It'd be useful to know what you're setting this up for. In this case, we're setting up a business account separate from these services. So if you click the or tap the other, go to add a mail account. Now for name, you can either enter your name if it makes sense for when the person receives your email. So if you're part of a bigger company and your name's John, that may or may not make sense. So you might put John and the company's name. If people are going to know you by your name, definitely just put your own name in there. If it's, for example, accounts, it might be worth putting accounts at that business name. So when it comes in, people know it's from that company. It's less likely to end up in the junk or somebody think it's part of a phishing scam. So this part, always make sure it's nice and descriptive and the person who's going to receive it will understand where it's coming from. In this part, your email address. Email addresses are always lowercase. So on your settings or on your paperwork or on the email you receive with your settings, it might show uppercase J and uppercase B in this case. That is just the software trying to be polite when it comes to somebody's name, putting alphabets at the beginning of their names. But when you're setting up, it's always lowercase. Enter the password. Hopefully that's nice and secure. We have got a video coming up on how to store all your passwords. So generally don't go for an easy password, but we've got a video on LastPass, a password manager, where you can enter your passwords and it can be a long string of complicated things, but you don't need to remember it. The software does it for you. Now, once we move on to the next screen, you'll see at the top, we've got IMAP and POP. I won't go into a deep dive. We've got a video that explains it into a lot more detail. But basically, IMAP, all your emails are stored on the server and all aspects of that email. POP, all emails are brought down from the server and are eventually deleted and they're stored on your local device. So now we need to enter incoming mail server. Now in most cases, it could be mail.yourbusinessdomain. So if you were Amazon, it might be mail.amazon.com. On some servers, we don't even use this, so we use something totally different. And in this case, we're using an external shared account. So it's actually looks like a whole different domain name. So just check your settings. Normally mail.yourdomainname, but double check it. Your username in most cases would be the same as your email address. Again, that might be different to some. Again, some of the servers we have configured do not use the email address at all, but in most cases it is the email address. and again check, because in some cases it might be, it might look like the email address, but the at sign's been replaced with a hyphen or something like that. So definitely worth checking these settings before you move on, because it's quite annoying if you think you've got it right and then you spend hours then notice you are one letter out or one character out. Now, I'm quite lazy. I know the settings for the outgoing servers is exactly the same as the incoming server, so I'm just going to copy and paste that. So if yours is the same, you can do the same. Again, same with the username for the outgoing server, SMTP. It is exactly the same as incoming. So copy and paste there. Now the password, you're generally only issued the one password, so that's the same password to be entered in both fields if it's requesting it. If this video has helped you come unstuck with setting up your emails, definitely give us a like, it always helps. Once that's done, you'll see a row or on the far column, all the ticks coming. That means that the server has accepted the details. If that fails, just double check your settings and then try again. Sometimes I have seen it needed to be confirmed that these were correct on two or three occasions before it would accept it. So as long as you've been issued the correct email settings and server settings, you may have to persevere with it two or three times. But in this case, it went through first time, not a problem. Then we come to this screen. We're just going to be using the mail service. I'm going to click to save that because I don't want to be using these settings every time I want to pick up emails. Now I'm just going to check my email account, see if there's any mails. Now this particular server sends a test one. There's that test one, nice and received. We've got videos on how to put your name and your business details at the bottom of all outgoing emails. So if that's something of interest, don't forget to click to subscribe so you don't miss that. We'll be showing it both on the mobile and also on the range of computers like PCs and Macs.